stretch out the hour hand. See where on the clock it lands. The last number it went by is the number 5. Stretch out the minute hand. See where on the clock it lands. Each line equals 1 minute. So the time is 5:06. Every number the hour hand goes by represents 1 hour of time. Can count the minutes out of 60, and you'll be telling time with me. Stretch out the hour hand. See where on the clock it lands. 9's the last number it went by, so the hour hand points to 9. Stretch out the minute hand. See where on the clock it lands. It's pointing right at the 5, so the time is 9:25. Every number the hour hand goes by represents 1 hour of time. Then count the minutes out of 60, and you'll be telling time with me. Stretch out the hour hand. See where on the clock it lands. The hour hand lasts past the 8, so the hour of time is 8. Stretch out the minute hand. See where on the clock it lands. It points to 4 precisely, so the time is 8:20. Every number the hour hand goes by represents 1 hour of time. Then count the minutes out of 60, and you'll be telling time with me. The hour hand is shorter always. It goes around the clock twice each day. First time round is AM, the second time it's called PM. AM starts at midnight's moon and continues until noon, so we call noon 12 PM, and it goes till 12 AM. Every number the hour hand goes by represents 1 hour of time. Then count the minutes out of 60, and you'll be telling time with me. We count 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 minutes on each clock we see. We count 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 minutes on each clock we see. Every number the hour hand goes by represents 1 hour of time. Then count the minutes out of 60, and you'll be telling time with me.
Visit numberrock.com for exclusive content, lesson materials, and more. Thanks for watching.